America, the land of opportunity, a country where your own resolution to succeed is more important than any other. Abraham Lincoln's words from 165 years ago still resonate today because of who we are and because of what we are. A country where a boy born into poverty in a log cabin, raised right here on the frontier of Indiana, could educate himself, become a lawyer, become a president of the United States who would preserve the Union, abolish slavery, and save the nation. As a fellow Hoosier, visiting Lincoln's boyhood home has always been a treasured experience for me and my family. It's a place that made Lincoln. It shaped Lincoln and defined the man that Lincoln would become. America is the land of opportunity. As President Donald Trump declared at Mount Rushmore, in America, you can do anything. You can be anything. And together, we can achieve anything. Every day, President Donald Trump is fighting to protect the promise of American liberty. Every day, our president's been fighting to expand the reach of the American dream. And on every single day, without fail, President Donald Trump has been fighting for you. So tonight, I'd like to introduce you to a few remarkable Americans who represent that solemn pledge, who embody our president's unbreakable devotion to ensuring that America is a land of unlimited opportunity for all. Jack is an 8-year-old from Wisconsin who was struggling academically and socially in school. But Jack's mom, Sarah, who works 3 jobs to support her son, applied for Wisconsin's school choice voucher program.
We're glad that we were able to get the school choice voucher to go to that school. With Jack, he would have slipped through the cracks in public schools, and having the option to go to a school that fits him has been a real game changer for us. And I know that because of that opportunity that he's going to succeed and he's going to achieve that goal of being an apparatus engineer, if that's what he chooses to stick with.
Laura McClinn is a mother of another inspiring boy, Jordan. Jordan has Duchenne muscular dystrophy, a fatal muscle weakening disorder. Jordan was at my side in Indiana when, as governor, I signed a law allowing terminally ill patients to access experimental drugs not yet approved by the FDA. In 2018, President Trump signed the landmark federal Right to Try bill into law. Thanks to the president's leadership, critically ill patients have the right to access life-saving experimental treatments.
We started fighting for Right to Try, which basically says if you have a terminal illness and there's a drug that exists and you don't qualify for the clinical trial, there's no other way to receive it. This is a unique pathway that allows you to have access. You made us a promise back in Indiana that you would do whatever it took to help Jordan, and we're so grateful that you joined us on this journey and stuck it out until it became law so that other people could access treatments.
So Jordan, if President Trump was standing right there, what would you say to him today about Right to Try?
Thank you for being a hero to everybody in the country.
Judge Cheryl Allen made history in 2007 when she became the first African-American woman to be elected to serve on the Pennsylvania Superior Court. It's because of leaders like Judge Allen that our nation has overcome our greatest challenges. In this time of racial division in the country,
yes,
do you see faith and values and
Absolutely.
The strong stand that President Trump has taken for equality of opportunity as a pathway toward bringing the country together?
As a senior citizen, I'll leave it at that. I know what racism feels like, but I also know that but for my being in this country, I would have never been able to achieve the things that I have been able to achieve. There are injustices, but the way to deal with those injustices is for people to sit down across the table and talk and come up with solutions. I do believe that President Trump is committed to that. In 2016, I have to confess that I really did not know candidate Trump at the time. But I have to say that he really won me over.
Gino's a truck driver from Ohio who heard politicians for years make empty promises about defending American jobs, only to see those promises broken again and again. But in 2019, when General Motors closed its plant in Lordstown, Ohio, President Donald Trump refused to stand by and watch it happen. And as Gino observed, this president reached out to General Motors to find a way to bring jobs back to Lordstown. And plans were soon set into motion to create Lordstown Motors.
President Trump says, this is how we fix it. And I thought, well, that's a simple solution. There's no other president could have done it. There's no one that has even tried to do it. President Trump's a doer. He appreciates every one of us, and I know he does. I've seen it. When he said, make America great again, that was his task. That wasn't his slogan. That was his task. And every hat you see that says MAGA on it, that's what your president's doing for you. Thank you, Mr. President, for keeping the promises that you made.
And then there's Pastor Aaron Johnson. Today, he's the executive director of the Tulsa Dream Center, a nonprofit that provides education and medical services and food to those in need. AJ, you've got a great personal story. When you see the way this president, this administration have been leaning in to create opportunities, investments in communities around the country to create jobs, expanding educational choice, what does that mean to the families that you serve every day?
It means so much to our families. I did grow up in a single parent home, and so we serve over 600 boys and girls right now on a daily basis, even in COVID. And so for us to give these moms to have an opportunity to take more money on their check, on their paycheck, home back to them, to have their children be able to go to a school that they may not have the opportunity to otherwise, it means so much to us. There's been so much greater opportunity for individuals to come together in any walk of life. People have really been able to see such a positive change and been filled with hope, especially throughout this time.
Lydia left hearth and home, friends and family in Honduras to pursue a better life here in America. While raising their four daughters, Lydia and her husband run a small business that creates security systems. But just months after their business was up and running, our nation was struck by a global pandemic. That's when President Donald Trump stepped in and enacted the largest financial relief package in American history. Her small business stayed in business, and her American dream kept running strong. What did the Paycheck Protection Program mean to your company as the coronavirus struck?
Yeah, it was a huge, tremendous help and a big blessing. And so we applied, we were accepted really quickly. We're so grateful. You can't believe how much relief we have. We want to continue serving our clients. We want to continue growing our economy, right? We want to all continue to move forward.
So we were able to make it. Because of the support of family and friends, the government. I tell my children, you know, they are born here in the U.S. And I tell them, you are so blessed to live in America.
Here at Abraham Lincoln's boyhood home, a young man would grow up to become the first Republican president of the United States. And today, another Republican president is fighting to preserve that same noble legacy of freedom. And President Donald Trump will make certain that the torch of American opportunity illuminates every city, every town, and every community in this blessed land.
Hi, I'm Ryan Holitz.